Hello, and welcome back to Football Fanbox. I'm Dan Jackson, and this is Travis Sosa. Usually, we start the show off with only say it if you mean it, but there are a few things bothering me, and they need to be addressed. One is, social media saying the Raiders are bringing football to Las Vegas. That's false. The Raiders are bringing an NFL team to a major football city. We're going to start this show with our Youth Football League highlights. Next year, we'll be giving scores and highlights for all their games. Roll the tape.
We'll be right back. That's what I'm talking about. Those kids can ball. Let's get into our next segment. Only say it if you mean it.
And I think they should start playing the Browns fans because the Browns suck. Happy New Year's, Mom!
Hi, my name is Tim. I'm a Patriots Nation fan. And the one thing I could change, if I could change anything, is that any controversial calls would be replayed automatically.
All right, I'm TJ Miller. If there's one thing I could change about the NFL, it would be commissioner. I've been a Patriots fan for as long as I can remember, and Roger Goodell has been, you know, targeting the Patriots ever since the Deflategate, and if I could change anything, it would be him. You know, that's all I got to say.
Hi, my name is Ariel, and I represent the Steeler Nation, and the one thing that I would change with the NFL commissioning is the fact that no NFL player should be allowed to...
Now I can get into the second thing that's bothering me, the New England Patriots. Not so much the Patriots as it is the teams they're playing. Seahawks, Falcons, Steelers. If you're playing New England and there's less than 2 minutes left and you have the lead, gather yourself, rethink your life, and run the ball.
Dan, relax. We're simply living in the Brady era. Let's roll the next set of highlights.
This time, Kamara.
This is Kamara. He gets the 45-yard touchdown pass. Gets into the end zone.
And a flag flies.
We'll be right back.
there is some serious football being played in Las Vegas.
Please believe me. Let's get into the money-making segment of the show with Bill and Sean. Get your money right.
And we're just two guys talking fantasy football.
Well, the season's over. Hope you all won your leagues out there. But if you didn't, next year is just around the corner.
Well, speaking of next season, Sean, we've got some exciting news. Football Fan Box will be hosting the very first citywide televised fantasy football contest.
I'm looking forward to that. We don't have all the details yet, but what I can tell you is Football Fan Box will be holding a citywide tournament for you, the fans of Las Vegas.
This contest will be like no other. The league will consist of teams of 10, and then the winner of each league will then advance to a tournament to determine the best fantasy football owner in the city.
Substantial cash prizes will be awarded, along with other prizes such as t-shirts.
Not only is Football Fan Box hosting this one-of-a-kind contest, we'll be covering the season, highlighting your teams right here on our show.
So stay tuned for more about this fantastic opportunity later in the spring.
There will be announcements coming soon, so make sure you subscribe to footballfanbox.tv and don't miss out on this amazing opportunity.
Don't miss out. Okay, Bill, that sounds exciting, but what about this season? I can't remember a season as crazy as this one.
Oh, me either, man. It's been insane. I mean, we've had key injuries to key players. We've had suspensions. We've had underperformers. We even had some breakout stars. It's been a great season.
Yeah, how about those injuries? Number one pick, David Johnson, first week. He's out. Odell Beckham starts the season injured. He comes back, plays really well. Then he's lost the rest of the season.
Yeah, tell me about it, Sean. I took a chance of him in the first round, and I was telling everybody, I told you so. I told you so. It's okay. It's okay. You know, he's going to be great. And then, boom, he's out again.
And we also had Aaron Rodgers go down.
Yeah, yeah.
Tell me there was a few people counting on him probably for the season. That didn't work out too well.
No. And then Deshaun Watson was having a breakout season as a rookie, and boom, down he goes.
He's a monster.
He is a monster.
He's going to be there. He's going to be one of the top picks next year.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. He's going to go in probably the first two rounds, I'm guessing.
Yeah. But you know, the key is to be good and active on the waiver wire. Absolutely. If you're active on the waiver wire, you got people like Nick Foles that lit it up toward the end of the season. Surprisingly enough, Blake Bortles.
Blake Bortles. Well, we talked about him last week.
He turned out to be a pretty usable
player. They were good guys to go after on the waiver wire. So sometimes, guys, we do know what we're talking about.
Yes.
Season has some breakout stars also, Sean. You had Alvin Kamara. What a beast he was.
He's a monster.
He was unbelievable. As soon as they traded Peterson away, guys, if you got him, congratulations, because you probably went all the way.
You know, I kind of wondered why they even drafted Adrian Peterson.
I have no idea why they went after him. He's a big name, big star, maybe. I don't know. But man, that Kamara, he's the future of that team there. We also had Adam Thielen. Knew a little bit about him coming out of the draft, but he's quite a player. He's going to be a star. He's going to be a fantasy point getter next year. So make sure you jump on that guy next year.
And how about Ezekiel Elliott?
How bad is he?
6 week suspension. When am I going to take it? When's it going to happen? And then he takes it just long enough to get into the fantasy playoffs.
Sure. But, you know, those who took the chance on him early, you guys reaped the rewards. You really did. But, you know, but at what cost? You know, every week you're wondering, is this the week he starts his suspension? Is this the week he doesn't? Do I have to go find somebody to replace him? I picked this guy up. But guess what? He's playing, so now I don't need this guy again. It was a complete mess. And then as soon as you thought you were free and clear, boom, there's your six-game suspension, and there goes your playoff hopes. Well, Sean, it's been a fun season. I'm really sad to see it end.
No worries. Next year will be here before you know it.
Yeah, I can't wait. You know, and I can't wait for the Football Fan Box Citywide Football Contest. That's going to be really exciting.
Yeah. Remember to subscribe to footballfanbox.tv so you don't miss out on anything.
Thank you for being with us. See you next season. Happy New Year. Stay Vegas strong. And now, back to Dan and Travis.
This week, we'd like to say thank you to Three Angry Wives Pub for having us, a New England Patriots bar that welcomes everyone. and with their great food and prizes.
I didn't get invited.
Neither did I.
Hello, my name's Emily, and this is Reggie. We're down here at Three Angry Wives, located at 88 West Charleston Boulevard.
We are known to be Las Vegas' premier Patriots bar, but we welcome all fans. We're famous for all of our Irish fare, our shepherd's pie, fish and chips, Irish stew. Come on down, all teams are welcome. We always have raffles for jerseys and t-shirts. Gift cards, and we're very excited to have the Raiders be here next year.
Our producer's niece would like to say a few words.
Hello, my name is Olivia from Vasiliadis Elementary, and I am a Raiders fan, and I'd like to give a shout out to the Cicado Savages and wish everyone a happy new year, especially the fam.
Thank you for watching from all of us at Football Fanbox. Stay Vegas strong, and make sure to check us out on Facebook and YouTube.
Also, have a safe and happy new year.
Hi, my name is Stacy. I'm a Green Bay Packer fan. I wanted to wish everybody in Vegas a happy and safe new year. Stay Vegas strong, go Packers.
Hello, I'm Vanessa, and I'm a Dallas Cowboys football fan, and I did fantasy football for the first time this year. I think I'm ready for the citywide fantasy football league. Go Cowboys!
Hi, my name is Rihanna, and I'm a Chargers fan, and I play fantasy football for the second time, and I think I'm ready for the citywide fantasy football. Go, baby!
Hi, my name is Rubina, and I'm a Rams fan. I play fantasy football for the first time, and I think I'm ready for the citywide fantasy football contest. Go Rams!
Hello, my name is Erin, and I am a huge Dallas Cowboys fan. I have played fantasy football several times, and I think I'm ready for the citywide championship. Go Cowboys!
Watch more Football Fanbox, or we'll come get you!